Good morning, students. We will continue with the cyber chapter. Now, in the case of cyber, there are one term that is called malware. So, malware stands for malicious software. So, malicious software means a software or application created for wrong purpose, clear? Malicious purpose. So that's why it is called malware. So it is a combination of two words, malicious, and second one is software. So malicious software means malware. So in malware, it is a common term given to the different softwares created for wrong intention. So first one is virus. Okay, so virus stand for vital information resource under seize. Clear? Vital information resource under seize means important your resources become disabled. Okay, वो वो disabled हो जाते हैं. This is but in a basically the, this is a the full form is given by IT experts. But in reality, virus is a word from biological virus. Okay, just like a COVID or another type of virus. So virus word वहाँ से आया. So virus is a small software that is created to disturb the normal working of your computer system. So if any software stop the normal working of your computer system, it's called virus. Clear? Second.
Spyware.
Yes, better. The second one is here, worms. Because the virus may harm your computer system, it can crash your hard disk, it can reboot your computer system, it can display the same message again and again. So from serious to normal effects a virus can be. Okay, but what is worms? Worms are self-replicating malware. It means it increase its quantity. Clear? Suppose there is a one worm in your computer, and after 2 days, it may be 2, then 4, then 8, 16, like this. It manipulate itself. Clear? So its drawback is it consume your hard disk storage. Clear? Otherwise, there is no any serious you can say effects of your worms. The worms consume your computer storage. Then number three, Trojan. So Trojan are very small program that look like a utility, but in reality, these are dangerous. They are deleting our files. Okay, for example, if you download any game from internet, you are playing the game, and while you are playing the game, the files are deleted from your computer system because there is a Trojan in that game. So Trojans are small softwares that look like a utility, but in reality, it is dangerous for your computer system. Here, this is called Trojan or Trojan horse. Trojan horses, okay? So, Trojan, next term is number four. Here is spyware. spyware is a software that gives the complete information that monitor the activity, your activity in your computer system, and give its information to another person. It is the spyware. And now present time, spyware is very common in mobile phones. It means whenever you are doing any work in your mobile phone, same with the help of spyware, the same screen is visible to the another person. So this is very famous and very common in mobile phones now. Spyware. Okay. So whatever you are doing in your computer system, every activity will be monitored and recorded, and then its information is given to the third person. Next is yes, beta Himanshu.
Worms.
Beta, worms are the application of small software that replicate itself. Suppose एक file में worms है, ठीक है? आज वो file एक ही आपके computer में, कल वो क्या हो जाएगी? 2 हो जाएगी, then 4, then 8, 16, ठीक है? Then 32, 64, doubling होती रहेगी उसकी. Clear?
Okay sir.
तो वो क्या करेगा? आपके computer की storage consume कर लेगा, hard disk consume कर लेगा, ठीक है? तो आपका this is only the drawback of worms. Otherwise there is no any harm to the computer system. Then there is adware. Beta, adware is a series of or arrays of advertisement. Whenever you are using internet, above your time display in status bar, there is an advertisement one after one. Okay? तो एक सीरीज बन जाती है, तो वो एडवर्टाइजमेंट आने लग पड़ती है. द ओनली ड्रॉबैक ऑफ एडवेयर इज इट कंज्यूम द बैंडविड्थ ऑफ योर इंटरनेट कनेक्शन. क्लियर? अदरवाइज देयर इज नो एनी हार्म. सो व्हेनेवर देयर विल बी एडवेयर इन योर कंप्यूटर सिस्टम, इट विल डिस्प्ले सीरीज ऑफ एडवर्टाइजमेंट इन योर कंप्यूटर सिस्टम. नेक्स्ट इज spamming. Beta, spams are some bulk emails or big emails received in your email ID. Sometimes spam are doubtful emails. It means suppose in a Gmail you receive one email and it is suspicious email. It means there may be virus. In that case, that email will go to the spam folder. Clear? So spamming means your doubtful emails. Number 7. Then creeper. So sweepers is a small program that delete all the files from your computer system, totally sweep your computer system. Then next is number 8, denial of service. Because denial of service means your computer system, your server stop to give the services. It means your server is hanged. It will not give the response. So whenever there is a big number of hit in any server, in that case, server stop the processing. ठीक है? वो आपने किसी server, किसी website को बंद करना है, तो आप उस website को अलग-अलग कितने computers में open कर लोगे? या आप suppose आपने Yahoo की website को बंद करना है, तो आप क्या करोगे? अलग-अलग computer में Yahoo की website open कर लोगे, इतने computers में कर लोगे? Ultimately, Yahoo की website का server बंद हो जाएगा. This is called denial of services. So it is not in a normal way. तो अगर आपने large scale में अगर the government ने किसी भी website को block करना है, तो वो denial of service attack हो जाती है. Isha, any doubt in these terms, beta?
No, sir.
Next is number 9. Phishing. Beta, phishing is a attempt to get sensitive data. Okay. Suppose you are receiving one email that now you will receive a prize money of 1 crore, and you click on that particular email, and then you fill your bank detail and password there, and after that you post 20,000 money withdraw from your account. It means this is a phishing attack. Phishing attack means trying to get sensitive information from you with the help of email ID or with the help of SMS or any other way. So this is called phishing. This is again a malware. Okay. So next is number 10. There is password guessing. Password guessing means try to fetch the password of any ID. Okay. So person is trying ki aapka ye password ye ho sakta hai, ye password ho sakta hai, password mein, because normally we take the password on your name or date of birth or mobile number. So password guessing means trying to get the password. Okay, you are feeding the password again and again in order to, but this type of your attack is now minimized, because whenever you are doing this, if for example in the case of online banking, the owner of the email, the online banking will receive the emails or messages that wrong password inserted. Clear? And after inserting some wrong password, your online banking account will be freezed for 24 hours. So these type of things are now not normal, not common. Okay. So these are the different terms. So next is the different damages of these malware. Clear? Damages caused by malwares. So it include deletion of damage of your damage or delete of or files. So normally these malware delete or damage your files. It may slow down your computer. It may invade your email program. Okay. It may eat or eating up all the disk space. This is due to the
protection settings में damage होती हैं. Protection settings जिसमें हम कोई password वगैरह करते हैं वो पे hack हो जाता है.
बेटा whenever there is a spyware or any other type of malware is here, it can the third person can view every activity. Suppose you are filling the password, so your password will be displayed. So everything is can be cracked with the help of malware.
Okay.
So eating up all the hard disk space. So these are the very very common damages. Sometimes hard disk crash, damage of hard disk. Clear? So the damages are from very normal to serious damage. Okay. Now next is, so we can say it is a your alter PC settings. Okay, you, if there are some settings by you in your PC, they can be altered, they can be changed by these malwares. Okay, next is, now these are the damages. Now these spamming, there is a different malwares are there. एंड यू कैन कंट्रोल देम विद द हेल्प ऑफ एंटीवायरस सॉफ्टवेयर. क्लियर? तो चाहे वो स्लीपर है, चाहे वो आपके पास देयर इज अ ट्रोजन इज देयर, देयर इज अ वॉर्म इज देयर, देयर इज अ वायरस, एवरीथिंग यू कैन कंट्रोल विद द हेल्प ऑफ एंटीवायरस सॉफ्टवेयर. Now there is another term that is called device dropping. This term is very common now, device dropping. So it means unauthorized monitoring of other person's communication. Okay, so whenever there is a spyware, it's a example of device dropping. The reason is because you are monitoring, unauthorized monitoring the activity of another person, unauthorized monitoring the other person communication. Okay, so this term is this is totally illegal according to the Indian IT Act. This is totally against the law. Clear? You have no any right to monitor the other person communication. Next is there is one more term that is called farming. Any student, what is farming? Deepak, yes, what is farming? Isha. Yes, beta, unmute yourself. Harshika.
Yes, sir.
Beta, what is farming? It's a very, very new term.
Sir, it is similar to fishing?
In some way, but not exactly. You can say 50% is similar to the fishing.
Okay.
But, suppose we open the SPA website, but in between the there is a redirection and you go to the another website. This is called the farming. Clear? तो आपने वेबसाइट कोई और खोल रहे हो और आपने कोई प्योर वेबसाइट पर गए, दैट इज कॉल्ड रीडायरेक्शन. तो आई एम टाइपिंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फार्मिंग. इट इज एन अटैक इन विच ए हैकर्स अटेम्प्ट to redirect a website traffic to another fake website or bogus website. So this is called a farm. Very close to the phishing. Okay. Suppose phishing. Suppose in place of online SBI website. Okay. So that's it. Online SBI.com. Okay. Website as SBI. So if you are getting the website SBI online. So in place of online SBI, if the name of the website is sbionline.com, so you will confuse that this will be the website of SBI. So you will click open this website, and then there will be some phishing effects will be there. ठीक है, क्योंकि आप वहाँ पे यूजर आईडी फिल करोगे, पासवर्ड फिल करोगे, दिस इज फिशिंग. तो फार्मिंग इज ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर टू द फिशिंग, बट हियर रीडायरेक्शन. You will open the online SBI website, sbi.com, and you will go to the another website. This is called farming. Next is, we can avoid these type of malware attacks.
Sir, आपने अनदर के बारे में क्या?
Yes, beta.
अनदर के बारे में क्या? कौन अनदर?
Bogus website or fake website.
Okay.
Next is solution for these threats. Okay, so there are some active protection, and there are some preventive protection or measurements. Okay, so in active protection, install antivirus software. ठीक है, तो एक्टिव प्रोटेक्शन से इंस्टॉल एंटीवायरस सॉफ्टवेयर एंड अपडेट दैट एंटीवायरस सॉफ्टवेयर इन रेगुलर बेसिस. बट इन ए प्रिवेंटिव मेजर्स देयर आर सम मेजरमेंट्स लाइक डोंट ओपन
अपडेट योर गैजेट ऑन डे बाय
अननोन
आफ्टर
ईमेल. ओके, डोंट ओपन unknown websites. Clear?
And unknown websites.
Yes. Okay. So these are preventive measures. So there are some
active. Sir, you update your gadgets, sir.
Yes. Yes. Clear? Yeah. These are the preventive measures. Okay. So update your antivirus software. Update your operating system. Okay, there are every daily there are some updations are given by the Windows, because these are for your safety purpose to update your computer system if you have a original Windows. Clear? So these are preventive measures. So in active measure means active protection, there are installed antivirus softwares, and that can protect your computer system from malwares. So in a active protection, I am using some steps here, some protections. One is use antivirus softwares. Second one, download updates of antivirus software. Then run frequent full system scan. So installing and updating of your antivirus software is not sufficient, beta. So run your full system scan in regular basis. Okay. Next is, and in the case of preventive, keep your use anti. Here is in a preventive. Don't open unknown emails. Don't open unknown website. Then keep your system up to date means if there are some updations are available in Windows, install them. Use version downloading files. It means don't use the downloading from any website. Use the general website for downloading. Then number 5, disable cookies. So these are available in your browser settings. So you will have to disable the cookies, because in cookies there are some sensitive data is saved. So you can use these type of preventive measures. Next is in your syllabus. I am checking your syllabus now. So we discussed malware, we discussed virus, we discussed Trojan, we discussed adware. Okay, so we have discussed all these things. Then we have already discussed safe browsing the web, identity protection, confidentiality, cyber trolling and bullying. These are the two things which we will have to discuss. Then there is a definition of cyber crime. A crime with the help of internet is called cyber crime, because cyber crime means in crime with the help of internet is called cyber crime. So there is a hacking is here, events dropping, phishing, fraud emails, ransomware. Okay, student, what is ransomware? Any student? Garup, what is ransomware? Ransomware. Yes, Garup.
Sir, it is a practice of holding money for some data of the person.
Yes, very close to that. Suppose a ransomware is download any file and ransomware is in come in your computer system will be blocked. Your files, your images, picture files or your video files, everything will be blocked, and the person will demand money to release them or releasing them. Okay, so if your data is very important, your professional data is there, in that case it will be very risky for you, because the your files will be in a unreadable format. So you can't view that, you can can't access that files. So this is called ransomware. That is ransomware. In fact, the attacks are very common present time. Okay, students, yes, tomorrow we will discuss there are some open source license, Creative Commons, IPL and Apache. Otherwise, maximum terms we have discussed. There are very few terms which we will have to discuss. So time is now over. Tomorrow we will continue with this the chapter cyber. Okay. So